Welcome students for today's class. Today we are going to see the 3 models. What is these 3 models? Now what is the meaning of your models? First we need to understand that this model is nothing but it is a technique. The first thing is we should know the model is nothing like a technique. So what kind of technique we are going to do? This technique we are going to use for the systems. So what kind of system? Now again the question will arise, on which kind of system we are going to utilize this model. So normally what we are going to do is the system whatever we are going to building up, okay, any example you take whenever you are going to building up with some of the explanations about that product, or you can specify how it is going to be work out. The developers think that how they are going to develop the product, or the customers also can think that if any additional requirements they can give or not. So all these things is nothing but when you will add together, you are going to build something. So whenever you will build something, that you are going to do it for the system. So you are using some techniques to build your product. Whenever you will do that, that is known as your models. So here I have some 3 variety of models that we will see each one how it is working out. Then we will do the activity on these models. So now what is my first model? That is my class model. The next one is my state model. And the last one is my interaction model. So how these models are going to work out? Remember, one more thing is also there. The model is nothing but it is like your diagrammatic representation of anything, of any product or whatever you are doing. Okay, that is a diagrammatic representation. So what we are going to do is whenever we are going for this class model, we will do some class diagram. Whenever we will go for state model, we will do some state diagram. And whenever we will go for interaction model, we will do some activity diagram or sequence diagram or use case diagrams. So this variety of diagrams we have to do in this model. If you will see your syllabus, you will find out that the first module only on your requirement gathering, how you are going to gather your requirement, whatever the stages we have, the first module is coming under your requirement gathering. But if you will move towards your second module, you can find out the design part. Everything, whatever the terms we are utilizing in this module, everything is switching towards to your designing part. So there will be variety of designing parts. So you should learn how you are going to design. So let's see, moving towards the next slide, you can see class model. So now what do you mean by class model? As we know that the meaning of your class is nothing but this is the structure, or this is the combination of your objects and their relationship. How you are going to describe this one? How you are going to take the class name? So class is nothing but your structure of your objects and the relationship. Let's take the example of your class itself. So now if I will take the class as 3D, so the class name is 3D. Who all are the objects here? The objects will be the students, and also the object will be the teacher. So now what all are the relationship they are having? The teacher is teaching to the student. A single teacher can teach to the single student, or else a single teacher can teach to the multiple students. And also in other way, the multiple students can give the teaching methodology from the multiple faculty also. So what is happening here? They have the relationship. The relationship in the sense they are interacting with each other. So that is nothing but that is your object, the student, the staff, all are your objects, and they have the relationship. When we will put all these things are together, that is known as our class. And also what I told you, that the class model is nothing but here it has to contain the class diagram. So what it will have? The class diagram. So you are going to do the diagram of this. How you are going to do this now? So you have to make the graph. So this class diagram is nothing but it is the graphical representation of all the nodes. Nodes in the sense, the objects. So this class diagram is a graphical representation of all the objects, those who are present in this class. So now, then what you are going to do? And also you have to show the relationship among the classes. And remember one thing, it is not mandatory that you should have only one class. You should have the multiple classes. Then whenever you will do the class diagram, you can connect all these class to each other. Suppose I have 3D class now. I have 3A, 3B, 3C classes also. What I can do? I can give the connection in between 3A to 3B, 3B to 3C, 3C to 3D. So now what will happen? The connectivity that we are going to show in the term of our class diagram. So this is nothing but this is your class model. We have to always, we have to design the class diagram in a graphical way. So next, we will just move to the next one. We will see what is the meaning of our state model. So remember, in this state model, only one thing is there, that is the object will change its state in any time. That is the major thing here in the state model. The object can change the state in any time. So now what do you mean by state? Suppose now you can say that the student, so I told you that the student is nothing but an object. So now the student state is active state. So now you can collect all the data from that student. Suppose the student bearing the USN number 1 is in the active mode now. So if he is in the active mode, you can get all the data from your database. But the USN, the student bearing the USN 2 is not in the active mode. It means that you cannot collect all the data of your second student, right? So that is nothing but the object can change at any time. So now if the second student wants to come for your active mode, he can come. No problem in that. So always the object can change. And also one more example, suppose one student is there in your 3D, now he wants to go to the 3C. So what he is doing? He is changing the class. So that is also possible in the state model. So whenever you are going to do all these things, here that also you have to represent by using this state model. Whenever you will do the diagram, you have to notify all the changes in this state model. So how we are going to do this? This state model will contain the state diagram. This is very easy to remember. Class model will contain the class diagram. State model will contain the state diagram. How this state diagram will look like? The state diagram you have to do by using this graphical representations of all the states, all the nodes to the states, you have to show by using the data flows diagram. We will see all these things in detail, how the diagram looks like, how it, you are going to give the connectivity and all. But for the timing, you should remember the state model. In this state model, the object will change over the time period. Whenever it wants, it can change. And that changes you should reflect in your state model. And it will contain the state diagram. And also this state diagram will be the graphical representation of all the nodes. Now moving towards your next one, it is nothing but your interaction model. So now let's see what is this interaction model. So this model is nothing but it is like you have to show how the objects are going to interact whenever any specified task will be given. Suppose you have given in the class like some task, how the students are interacting, that is nothing but that you are going to show in the term of your diagram, that is known as your interaction model. how the interactive way, you have to show the interactive way of the student. But how you are going to show, it cannot be only one diagram. You have to follow these diagrams. The first one will be use case diagram. Next one will be your sequence diagram. And the next one will be your activity diagram. In detail, we will see how all these things are working. So what will happen in your use case? It will contain all the functionality. What it will contain? All the functionality of the system. What in proper system or in the class, whatever the functions are there, like the students wants to run, they want to walk. So all these things, you can take it as your methods or you can take it as your functions. So that things is known, the use case, normally it will only focus on how many students can run well, how many students can walk well, how many students can do cycling well. All these things are nothing but your methods or functions. So from your 3D class, when you will take the individual student's use case, your like particular thing, you are going to focus on that, on walk or on run or on cycling or on bike riding. So everything will be your individual thing. You are focusing on individual things. That time, that is known as your use case. Now, what do you mean by sequence diagram? The sequence diagram will show the object that interact and the time sequence of their interactions. So what will happen here? Actually, here you have to show that whenever the object is interacting, then how much time it is taking to interact? What is happening actually that time? All these things in detail, you are going to show in your sequence diagram. The last one, what is that? It is nothing but your activity diagram. What is this activity diagram? It will elaborate the important processing steps. All the steps to from the beginning to end, all the activity. Now for the use case, this things is going on. For the sequence diagram, that is going on. So all in detail, you are going to show everything in your activity diagram. So these all are nothing but it is about your three models, all the models, class model, state model and interaction model. You can get the question for your 6 marks in your VTU exam, like explain the 3D three models used in your object oriented technology. So you, this question used to come also. So this is all about your three models.